In this video, we're going to talk about executors. And what are executors? Executors are physical keys, buttons, knobs, faders you can find on the GrandMA3 hardware. They can also be represented as on-screen virtual executors and can be viewed and operated in the playback window. If you want to know how it works, be sure to watch the video all the way to the end, as I will go through all the different functionalities you can find in the GrandMA3 console and the keys and all the faders and buttons and configuration of those. But how do we work with them? How do we assign sequences to them, and what else can we do with them? So let's start here and look at the screen here. If you don't have this window here, if you push this little button right down here, you will open the overview of the executors of the first 10 faders on your console. And the first 10 faders right here is, or the first 10 sections, because it's not only the faders now. On the GrandMA2, you would have a fader. Below that fader, you would have a button, and above that fader, you would have two buttons. Those four items were tied together. If you stored something on your fader, those two buttons on top of the button underneath would be one and the same thing. It would all manipulate the same cue list or whatever you had on your fader. The bottom row on the GrandMA2 was on its own, and you could store stuff on that independently on what you did on the faders. The GrandMA3 changed up a little bit. Now you have rows here. You have row 101, 201, 301, and 401, as you can see in this window. 101 represents the bottom row down here below the faders. 201 represents the next row here, and they are tied into the fader. I'm going to show you this in a minute. But 201 and the fader is basically one and the same thing. You can have one function here, and of course you can turn the fader up and down. 301 is this button up here, and the first knob you can find right here. And 401 is the same. It's the button here and the rotary knob on top of it. But how does this work? How can we manipulate it? How can we store cue lists to, or sequences to the faders? And how can we have the go buttons we want, the go minus button we want, the top button we want, the flash button we want? That's kind of a different way and a different approach that that we used to have in the GrandMA2. But let me show you right here. We have the playback window up here as we built last time. And as you can see here, I deleted all my sequences and we are ready to build some new ones. So let's just build a sequence here with all our Vipers in our, let's say our position number one at full. We give it a magenta color and we store this in sequence number one. We name the sequence again. We just call it master cue list. There we go. As I showed you in the last tutorial, you can simply assign this cue list by writing assign down here. Remember your shortcuts down here. If your shortcuts are active, you can simply use the shortcut menu, which is pretty powerful. So assign the master cue list to 201. Now we assigned our cue list here to the bottom button down here in the bottom and the first fader. And that's it. These buttons on top and the button below it is not tied into this one yet. But we can do that if we want to. To be able to do that, we have to go in and manipulate whatever is going on our screen here. So if we press here where it says master cue list, this window opens. And if this window doesn't open the same way on your machine as it does on mine, it's because I set it to window number two, or screen number two, right here. And then when I open it, I can simply say, where do I want it to open? So if it opens on screen number one, you can simply say, I want it to open on screen number two. Let me show you real quick. To be able to manipulate what's going on in this cue list, or maybe extend it and make use of the other buttons and rotary knobs on this fader, on this sequence, you can simply go into master cue list here and push it. It opens up a new window, but to be able to compare it to what we're doing, we need it to open in another window. So if we go up here into the small screen here, you push it and you say, I want it to open on internal screen number two. You push that one and it opens in its own window. It's probably going to open if you have two screens. It's probably going to open on the other screen. So you basically just take it over here and then we can see what we're doing. We stored our cue list here on number 201. This is the 200 range here. If you store the next queue list on this one, it's going to be in this row right here. So let's do some manipulation. We can extend the queue list and say, right now, I want to make use of the button above it, which is this button and this rotary knob up here. So I can just push this one. And as you can see, this extends the queue list or the sequence to the next row of buttons. And now we can make use of the button above it and the rotary knob above it if we want to. We can do it again and say, I want even more room, and we can push to 400 and it goes all the way up. We can't choose the one below it for some reason. But what we can do is we just close this window down again. We simply delete the queue list right here. And instead of assigning it to 201, we can simply assign it to 101. And if we go into the queue list again, now we can extend it up and make use of stuff above it. So it starts from the bottom and it goes all the way up. You can actually extend it to the side as well if you want to, and then have even more buttons to manipulate if you want some learn buttons or whatever, macros or something between it here. That's also possible. And you can do that if you want some more functionality, some more buttons to make use of. We're not going to do this in this case. To delete this row we just extended it to, just press the one again. This is the way it functions. This is the way it works. Press number two, it extends to your right. Number three, it extends to your right. And back down if you just take it that way and then delete it that way. So now we have the 100 range, which is the bottom button. The 200 range, which is the next button and the fader, and we can extend it up into the 300 range, which is the next row of buttons, and so on. So let's say, okay, what do we want to do here? I would like this one to go to the top of my cue list. Say I have 10 cues with all my colors in, for instance. I would like this one to go to the first cue. So I push it and set it to top, and that's the way it's going to work now. The next one is my Go Plus. And for some reason, I want my bottom one to be Go Plus and the next one to be Go Minus. So we choose that one and say Go Minus. So let's just close this down and see where we're at right now. We have our master cue list here, and we have our top button, and we have our Go Minus, and we have our Go Plus. To be able to see a little bit better, I actually built a different view. So we can go into our faders and buttons here, and this extends the playback window so we can better see what's going on. We have our fader here, we can take it up and down. We have our rotary knob, we have the top button and Go Plus and Go Minus button down here. Let's just clear what we put in the programmer before. So let's build a few extra cues. I choose all my vibes, I put them into white and into the audience, for instance. I store this on my master cue list and I create my second cue as we talked about in the last episode. Let's do it again and say I need a cyan color and I put it into my position one and I store this as cue number three. So there we go. We now have three cues in our cue lists. So let's just clear out here and say now we have our Go Minus and Go Plus. We are currently in cue number one. I can say Go Plus to cue number two, Go Plus to cue number three, and then it goes all the way back. But if I go into cue number two, and say we have 10 cues here and I just want to go up to the top where my white color is, or open white color, I can just push the top button and it goes straight up regardless of how many cues there is in it. We can also assign the rotary knob to do different things. So let's just go back into our setup window here and say my encoder left, I want this to be a Go Minus button, and you can see it recognizes it over here. My encoder to the right needs to be a Go Plus button, for instance. So here we go. Now we have the option of turning your cues up and down with the rotary knob. And we can even go further and say, if we put something down here, this is what it does when the rotary knob is rotated but pushed down at the same time. But let's not do that in this episode. You can also change the functionality of your master if you want it to be, for instance, a temp fader, or let's just put it back to master again. But there is about a gazillion different options in here in the settings of every sequence. But that's for a different tutorial. Right now you can check out one of the other videos from our channel. They are linked on the screen right now, And please like the video and maybe even subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss any future episodes from us. Thank you for watching this time, and I hope you'll check out the next video. Bye-bye.